Good morning, my brothers and sisters. Welcome to episode number 4 in Be With Me. We're in the book of Philemon. I'm going to title today, A Benefit From You. That is, Paul is saying to Philemon, I want to see some production from you. I want to see a benefit. Because you're a Christian, I want to see a benefit out of you. I don't want you to sit there being a Christian. I want it to have an effect. So Paul has prayed that the fellowship of Philemon with Jesus and the fellowship that Philemon has with Paul and the fellowship he has with the church, that it makes a real difference, that it's active, that it's effective, that it has a result. In other words, Paul has called in his personal marker and also the marker because he's a member of the church. Because you have Christian fellowship, because you're in our family, because you have unity, because you're a partner in the gospel. In other words, because you're experiencing koinonia, that's what all this that means, I want you to extend that to another person, kind of who doesn't deserve it, just like you didn't deserve us. His name is Onesimus, so I want you to give koinonia to him. This is from Philemon, this is verse 15. For this, perhaps, is why he, that's referring to Onesimus, who ran away, was parted from you for a while. Let me start over. For this is perhaps why he was parted from you for a while, that you, Philemon, might have him back forever. So it's the call to have him back forever. So this is going to change everything. Verse 16, no longer as a slave, but more than a slave, as a beloved brother, especially to me, but how much more to you, both in the flesh and in the Lord. So that's verse 16. So I want you to have him back, not as a bondservant, not as a slave, not as in a lifelong working relationship, which is what both of those things are about, but as in a forever family of the church, of being of God's people, forever fellowship, forever being a church partner, as a beloved brother. So the call to have him back is not just to have him back in some sort of an economic way. It's a call to have him back in the highest of calls. That is a part of the body of Christ. Verse 17. So, then here Paul's calling his markers a little bit. So if you consider me your partner, your koinonia, receive him as you would receive me. I received you, and Christ received you as the runaway bunny. We talked about that yesterday. So you should start thinking about him, Onesimus, as the runaway bunny, the prodigal son, if you will. Receive him back. And Paul is asking Philemon to restore and have this new relationship with Onesimus. He's the runaway bunny sort of at the outset of the story. But by the time we get through the story, it's Philemon. He said, remember, you were the runaway bunny. That's why you should accept and receive back this runaway bunny who wishes to be forgiven. So verse 18, if he is, now Paul is going to really put himself on the line here. If he has wronged you at all or owes you anything, charge that to my account. That's verse 18. Then verse 19, he repeats it. Verse 19, I, Paul, write this with my own hand. I will repay it. To say nothing of your owing me, even your own self. So Paul says, charge it to me. This dispute that started between believer and non-believer has now been upgraded. Now it's a dispute between believer and believer. Why? Because Onesimus has become a believer. And it reminds me of that passage in 1 Corinthians 6:7, where it talks about lawsuits among and disputes among believers. And Paul concludes that and says, why not rather suffer wrong? Why not rather be defrauded? Why not take a financial hit? People are more important than money. People are more important than being right. The Christian church is, Jesus' body is more important than, you know, than standing your ground. It's a beautiful posture that one believer can take with regards to the other. And he's calling to that beautiful posture. Paul says, I will repay. And I think he really means it because he says twice, if I can restore two brothers and have them be a good example in Colossae, which is where they both live, wouldn't that be an amazing thing? Wouldn't that be a great encouragement to the church? So then finally, verse 20 today. Yes, brother, I want some benefit from you in the Lord. Refresh my heart in Christ. He said, I want to see some action from you. I want you to have a benefit from you that's demonstrable. I want your relationship with me, verse 19, and your relationship with the Lord, verse 20, to produce something. Way back in verse 6, it says, I want your faith to be productive. I want it to be able to bring about. I want your faith to have an effect. So we're shooting for, in this particular case, in my opinion, the second hardest thing in Christendom, which is forgiveness and forgetting and putting somebody's sins against you behind. That's, you know, this is a hard thing that Paul is asking Philemon to do. He's asking him to forbear when wronged. So he's saying to Philemon, you're a Christian. Now I want you to act like it. So the practical things for all of us today, maybe there's going to be this moment when Paul can kind of speak from the ages and say the same thing to us. Is, hey, Christian person, I want to see a benefit from you. I want you to have your faith be productive. I want it to be real. So maybe it's in a matter, like here in this particular book, where forgiveness has to go from one Christian to another. That's brutal. Or maybe it's in, I want you to be productive in boldness. Or maybe I want you to be productive in your mind, in purity, or in discipline. Or maybe I want to see some benefit in prayer, or in kind words, or the words that come out of your mouth. Or maybe I want to see a benefit in worship. I want to see you act like the Christian that you say you are. So Paul is saying today, and I think it's a call for all of us, is if you're a Christian, if you have koinonia, if you have fellowship with Christ, if you have fellowship with other believers, I want to see a benefit. So today, let's go, and I want to see a benefit from everybody, including myself. Thanks for listening.